Good evening and welcome to Goa 365. I'm Amanda Alfonso. First, the headlines. SEZ Hatao Yatra flagged off from Walpoi. Goa government wakes up to the damage to be caused to Goa's ecology if the Khalsa Bandura project on the Madhe River is allowed. MLA Anil Sargamkar offers to pay Rs 130 crores for the Meditab land at Kheri. And Sporting Club the Goa holds Sargamkar Sports Club to a draw at the ONGC Football League. Now for our top stories. Goa's movement against SEZs yesterday launched their SEZ Hatao Yatra from Walpoi with many NGOs along with the Bharatiya Janata Party joining in.
The Yatra will travel through the nook and corner of Goa, educating people on the ill effects of SEZ and culminate in a public meeting at Azad Maidan, Panjim on 18 December. Madhe Bachao Abhiyan convener and former MLA Nirmala Sawant explained the purpose of the rally.
Yatra is to awaken the people about the disadvantages of SEZ. SEZ in no way is going to help Goans, but it will be a stress on the existing infrastructure. We do not have enough water. If additional people come here, we'll have to share the water. There is congestion on the road.
In its bid to create awareness amongst the people, vehicles decorated with anti-SEZ banners and some fitted with loudspeakers went around the area. Pamphlets were also distributed to the people. Bharatiya Yuva Morcha State President Ashish Shirodkar identified the needs of Goa while asserting that the state did not require SEZs, which in his opinion would destroy the Goan identity.
We Goans don't want SEZ. We want good roads, good water supply, good electricity. In fact, Goa also requires garbage disposal plants. This is not being solved by Goa government. There will be migrations to the tune of 15 lakh people coming in Goa and settling down in Goa, which will directly impact the infrastructure, which his total identity will get diluted in this new population migration. To save SEZ, to save Goa, we have to oppose SEZ.
Addressing the rally, Goa's movement against SEZ convener Mathani Saldana squarely blamed Pratap Singh Rane for hoisting SEZs on Goans.
जन्ना काँग्रेस मुट्टा ओल्लो जबाबदारी तेका जाऊन आसा प्रताप सिंग राणे कारण प्रताप सिंग राणेन कॅबिनेट डिसिजन दिकूंक घेयनासतना तेजी चौकशी करिनासतना पैशे मेवता म्हूण वोटरा एसईझेडाची एप्लिकेशना मुखार धाडलेली आसा. आयज गोंयां 30 आनी 5 वर्सां जालीं प्रताप सिंग राणेची फॅमिली राज चलयता आनी गोंयचे निसंटन करत घातलेले आसा. हे सग महाराजा मोगाचे हांगा ना, हिंगा लोकशाही आसा आनी लोकशाही हाय लोकशायेक लोकांक जाय तेच सरकारान करपाक जाय आनी न्हय दिगंबराक ओ प्रताप सिंग राणे आनी तिसरो आयला तो विस्पाची ताक जाय ते करपाक आमची लोकशाही ना.
He also painted a bleak picture of Goa once the SEZs are established, wherein Goans would be reduced to a minority in their own land.
दिसांनी 2 लाख तरी लोक आयलो जाय उदीक आमकां हातांत ना, बिजली आमकां हातांत पावना आनी वो कचरो जो आहा आख्ख्या गोंयांत जाता तो घालपाक जागो ना. ही परिस्थिती जाल्ली आहा आनी मातशे विचार करात, 30 आनी 2 लाख लोक तरी गोंयांत आयलो परिस्थिती कितें जातली. वयलो मार्ग जो येता तो तुमचे शिरिस्यो वो तुमचे एडुकेशनल इंस्टिट्यूशन डॉक्टर वो कोण इंजिनियर वो कोण आय टी आय वो आय टी जावपाचे भुरग्याचो जागो तो घेतलो जबड पडट्यो वाडटल्यो सांगवाडे.
He urged the people to gather in large numbers on 18 December for the protest meeting at Panjim's Azad Maidan, where last year on the same day a massive protest meeting was held to demand scrapping of the Goa Regional Plan 2011. North Goa MP Shripad Naik, while castigating the ruling Congress for its anti-people policies, reiterated that the proposed SEZ would not benefit Goans in any way.
तुम्ही वाचले असतले सुनामी कशी फाटी झाली आणि अख्ख्या या पूर्वेच्या किनारपट्टीचे उत्तरेच्या पश्चिमेच्या किनारपट्टीचे कितलेशे लोकांची घरं उद्ध्वस्त केली. तशी अशी जगाची सुनामी जी असा या काँग्रेस सरकारने आणली असा आणि या सुनामी आमच्या सगळ्याचे गोयकारांचे गोयपण आणि गोय नष्ट करपाचा प्रयत्न या सुनामी हाडून करपाचा प्रयत्न असा अशी जे हाडून तो काँग्रेस सरकारने स्वतःच्या फायद्या खातीर केला.
After much delay, the state government seems to have woken up to the fact that construction of the Khalsa Bandura project on the Madai River would spell doom for the state. But even then, the state government is deciding to file an affidavit in the Supreme Court, bringing to its notice that the Karnataka government has committed contempt of court by restarting construction at the site.
Chief Minister Digambar Kamath informed the media that the delegation deputed by Water Resources Department to check the veracity of the disclosure made by some NGOs that the neighboring government had restarted the work has said it was true.
Minister of Water Resources have also come to know that Karnataka has started some work there. Ministry has already dispatched a team there to actually do the assessment, also collect photographs and evidence as to what type of work is being going on there. As soon as government gets the report of the team, we will file an affidavit or the status report in the Supreme Court, bringing to the notice of the Supreme Court the facts with evidence.
Briefing media persons, Water Resources Minister Philip Neri Rodrigues said that the government have sought Supreme Court's intervention to have regular hearing on this matter.
See, we are expecting a regular hearing next month, but if we don't get a date for hearing, we will mention to the Supreme Court maybe on next Monday, and we may send our Advocate General to Delhi to make a special mention before the Supreme Court, which may happen on next Monday. So we can convey to the people of Goa, for we know that lot of apprehension and anxiety creates in the minds of people of Goa about the diversion. So again, time and again, we are expressing that we have enough faith on the Supreme Court.
On other issues, Chief Minister Digambar Kamath said he has fulfilled his promise made to the people of Sankeli and Bicholim to constitute a committee to carry out mitigation measures to prevent flooding.
Process has already started. Meetings are also started as regards to Sakali, and I think whatever suggestions are there are being taken into consideration. They have also suggested some public hearings in Sakali and Bicholim so as to get the first hand view, which we plan to do in near future also, so as to avoid the recurrence of floods in both these areas.
Water Resources Department Chief Engineer Sandeep Nadkarni disclosed about the measures taken by the department to stop soil erosion on the beaches of Goa.
Government of Goa has approached Central Water and Power Research Station, Kadakwasla, which is the nodal agency for suggesting measures to tackle the sea erosion. And as per whatever suggestions we have received from them, we have already prepared two proposals, one for Kiri and one at Sunset, which Vedarbhati. And we have already processed the proposals. As regards to other this, we are awaiting measures from Central Water and Power Research Station, which we anticipate very early.
We'll spill into a short commercial break. Stay with us.